Back to healthcare now. Two stunning new government reports are out today on Obama's botched insurance exchange rollout. The Inspector General reporting both problems with online security as well as millions of website inconsistencies involving things like people's citizenships and income. Republican Senator Jerry Moran blasting the White House on this. He says, quote, "Once again, we're provided further evidence that Obamacare is not working. In fact, the administration is relying on nothing more than the honor system to run a billion-dollar program." So how's that working out? Here comes our good panel. Bob Beckel is former Democratic campaign manager and co-host of The Five, and Rich Lowry is the editor of the National Review and Fox News contributor. So they got the IG to look over everything, Bob, to see how it's going. And these reports are government-generated reports, which show some pretty scary things. They show that the Obamacare system lacks internal controls to verify information provided by individuals who are enrolling. That a problem?
Well, sure, it's a problem, but I mean, it's going to take some time to work it out. I mentioned to somebody that Medicare took a good decade before they had internal controls.
What were they doing for the first 2.5 years before they rolled it out?
Well, this has nothing to do with internal controls. I mean, the question is on the honor system. We rely on people on the honor system to pay their taxes, and then a lot of them pay their taxes. So I think most people will be straight about it, and you're going to have this percentage that are not going to be.
So, Rich, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. These things happen.
This obviously is not the way the system is supposed to work. It's supposed to be fully automated. You put in your income, other information, and the exchanges verify it against other government databases, reconcile any inconsistencies, and you don't have any federal workers really have to be involved at all. And this is the first time the federal government was going to run a system like this. It's been a complete disaster. And what happened was when in the initial meltdown, when the website was crashing and people couldn't sign up, they're so desperate just to get some minimal efficiency that they let all this stuff go, all the verification, and it's working on the honor system. And sure, as we're speaking, billions of dollars of erroneous payments are being made.
I've been thinking about this a lot lately. Okay, we've been hearing on a number of fronts that the government has lousy systems, that the computer systems don't work. And I remember hearing it after 9/11. The FBI said, well, you know what one of our problems is? We have computers from the 70s. They don't talk to each other. We can't communicate. We can't share information. Then we hear the IRS has a terrible computer system. It loses information. Now you've got this brand new system that was developed. And I think that, you know, you put all those things together. You've got defense, healthcare, and the IRS, and we're being told that on all three fronts, the government simply can't handle the technology.
Well, it can't handle the technology. There's a lot of information going in, a lot of information coming out. For the most part, it works.
Does it work, Bob?
It works in the IRS. It works fine.
No, it doesn't work in the IRS.
Why?
The IRS just told us that they can't even keep track of their own emails, for God's sakes.
Listen, you take something the size of what the IRS has to put through every year, hundreds of millions of pieces of data, and there's going to be some breakdowns. Yes, they could use some better technology. So could Obamacare. It will work.
But right now, you are being an apologist. Do you hear yourself? You are apologizing for this. We're the greatest nation in the world, and we're just supposed to go, oh, you know, stuff happens. It's not really a problem.
Obamacare is working just fine.
Well, look, Rich, is it working just fine?
What the government is good at is cutting people's checks. That's it. If there's anything more complicated than that, it's not good at it. And you're absolutely right. The IRS can't even keep emails. Most people in America can't get rid of their emails. If there's an embarrassing email or an email that's caught up in a lawsuit they want to destroy, they can't do it. Only the IRS can lose thousands and thousands of extremely sensitive emails.
Does that work pretty well?
Well, look at the Veterans Administration. Look at the Veterans Administration, Bob. This is a national commitment to care for veterans, and you have a bureaucracy that is taking care of itself and faking data to try to hide its inefficiency. So what you want is not to empower bureaucratic systems in the 21st century.
What is your alternative? This is what it gets down. Let's get right down to the lick log here, right? You don't want government. I happen to think government serves a purpose. Who's going to do what you say? Who's going to be the
insurance?
Air traffic controllers? Who's going to take care of the veterans?
What you do, you can give people a tax credit to buy their own health insurance, and you don't need to create this bureaucratic monstrosity.
We know, probably we cover more people.
I guess what I don't understand from your side, Bob, is why don't you demand that it work? Why don't you say, look, you know what? This is an embarrassment. We created this system. It's something Democrats feel passionately about and don't stand for it.
Well, we do try to insist that it gets better, but I don't think the capitalist system works very well. So there you go. I mean, I think that is full of
So we just throw our hands up on both sides. The government doesn't work, capitalism doesn't work.
You're talking about a country of 315 million people.
So you're saying it's hard.
It does take a lot of technology, a lot of work. You know, you all want to turn it over to the free market system, which has proven to be a total embarrassment when it comes to dealing with people's savings and other things, where none of them went to jail. They should have, by the way. They put us through the greatest recession in the world. It was the government that pulled us up.
Amazon.com works pretty well. Google seems to know what they're doing.
Without the capitalist system, we'd all be sitting on dung heaps, poor as dirt, on a dollar a day. The capitalist system is the greatest wonder in the world. Lifted hundreds of millions of people out of poverty just the last few decades.
That's exactly right. As Winston Churchill said, it's next to everything else, right? It's a capitalist, and democracy
is the best system.
Yep. It certainly didn't prove to be the best system when it put us into a great recession.
Everything's a fallen world. Everything's flawed, but it's better than
that's right. Well, government
better than
be flawed.
A dung heap, I'll tell you that. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Thank you, Bob. Happy 4th of July.
You too.
Have a good time in Vermont, Rich.